Now we're going to show you the menu system of your DJI Osmo Action 3. On the left side, press and hold to turn it on. On the right up corner, we have the battery indicator. And if you press on it, it will show you in percent how much power you have left. And here you have the zoom. Click and hold, or press and hold, then you can zoom. And here you have the settings. And now I am at the video, 4K at 69, at 60 frames per second. And you can just tap where you want to go, or you can drag. And same here, up here, you can drag or tap. With 1080 you can go all the way up to 240. And up here on the right you have a rocksteady. Tap on it. And you have rocksteady, horizon balancing. And you have even more in a lower resolution. And on this one, it's just like a GoPro. You can click up here or press up there to go back. That's new on DJI. Here you can set on a loop if you are using the camera as a dash cam or something. And on the left here, tap. You can see playback if you have anything on the memory card. And on the right side, just tap there. And here you have professional or standard. Priority in low light. And here, if you want to record in low light with the stabilization, you need to deactivate the Pro Mode. And on the right side, press tap, you have exposure. I have put it on automatic now, but you can put it in manual. Then you can also choose auto ISO. And confirm. But I'm gonna put it on auto again. Confirm. Then you have white balance. I have choose 5500. You can put it on automatic also. But it's better to just set it what you want to be, so it's a stable white balance. But for underwater, they recommend you to put it on automatic. Color, normal, or desync-like. And field of view. I have on D-Warp. But you can click, you can choose wide, ultra wide. But I find D-Warp is look good enough. And also here you have the microphone channel. This one has stereo sound, but you can choose mono or stereo. And wind reduction on and off. I find that when you use it on, it's really good. It have a microphone underneath, so it will reduce the wind. And audio direction, front, off. I just keep it on off. And you have the menu, just drag down. Here you can set up different settings for quick switch. And quick switch is a button on the side here. And here you can have the quick switch. You can choose what it want to do. Screen switch. I have put my ordinary video settings in a quick switch. And I have disabled photo, but I have video, slow motion, and hyperlapse, not time lapse, because hyperlapse is what I mostly use. Then we have settings here for brightness. I put in really low, just to save the battery. Up here, you have snapshots. For this one, when the camera is turned off, you can just press and hold and it will start recording. And I put it on video. And here we have, when it's locked, if it's single screen, like front or back. If a both bar on or not. Voice control. You can choose what language I had it on English, but I don't use voice control. Scuba diving. With scuba diving, you can use the button on the left to start and stop recording. And wireless connection, you can choose between 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. And new in Osmo Action 3, video compression, H.264 and HEVC. HEVC is actually H.265. So, for all you people who have wanted the H.265, now we have it. And sound is for the camera. I have muted the whole sound. And here you have grid. You have none, grid, diagonal, or grid and both, yeah. I could choose it on the grid. Anti-flicker, I have an auto. And also new on the menu here, you can choose the folder name. You can only change the last three one. And same here with file name. You have the last three things you can change. And here we have screen off when recording. I have it on 30 seconds. Here also, auto power off. I put it on 5 minutes. But you can choose 30 seconds and even 30. And LED, I put it off. You see a LED or an off. And here we have horizon calibration. So you can put it on clean, flat surface, not a clean, flat surface, and you can calibrate. And if you use it for streaming, here you have you can continue the last live stream. And the language for menu, I have it in English. And date and time. Here you format your SD card. Just slide it to format. Like this. It's really fast to format this one compared to other brands like GoPro. Factory reset. If it's you want to reset to factory settings. Here you have a orientation lock on or off. Here you can lock the screen. Then you have to slide up to open it. Here voice control on or off. And here full front screen, but I have turned it off. HDR. They say it's HDR on this one. Usually you just click on a quick switch here, but I couldn't find it. And I didn't find it in menu. But on quick switch, we press on it, and you can switch between different modes. And to choose between video or photo or slow motion, you can press and hold there, or press there, and you can slide between. Or you can just slide. Now it's on slow motion. Press down there. Then you can set the settings. I have it in 4K. We have 2K and 1080. But I always choose the highest resolution. And same hyperlapse. Here you can set it all the way from automatic, 2x, all the way up to 30. Mostly I use 10. And here you also have a time lapse. Here you can set the different settings for you can fold, sunset, crowds. If it's not in 4K, you need to press and hold, or press up here. Because I think it's standard on 1080. So remember it for all the settings. And up here, you can choose between night and day. Also, you have here, you have new settings for everyone. But choose this right white balance or the same white balance as you use on the other one. If you combine different clips, like hyperlapse or ordinary video. And they say that this Tinova adapter from the old one, from the old Osmo Action, work on this one. It fits, but I never managed to get any sound from it. I'm gonna turn the camera on. No microphone icon. I plug the microphone in. And still, no microphone. I've even tried to go into settings here. microphone, nothing work. I mean, maybe mono, no, not even with mono settings. Maybe it will work in a later firmware settings, but for now it's not working. If you look at my old Osmo Action, now you can see an icon up there showing it's connected with the sound. To put on the side door again, you have to check that it's slide all the way out. Hold it straight up and press it down. Like this. And now it's on. Take it off. All the way up. And up. And for the battery, it's on the right side. You have this door here. You just slide it up. Here you have a flip for the battery. Put it out. Drag it out. Here you have the memory card. And press in, and then you can take it out. I bought a brand new Lexar 128 for this camera. To put it in, it's easier to put it in when the battery is out. Face out. Just press until you hear a click. And for the battery, always check which side it is. Just put it in, close the door. And if you see orange here, it's not waterproof. So press and hold until you hear a click, and it's waterproof. Same with the other side. And how fast can this camera start recording? Well, it's off now. So, 1, 2, 3.